fucking Polak.
Hey, you got that camera? Professor Ken.
Perfect.
Super.
Nobody knows.
All right, begin.
Shh. Don't we tell all know. Anybody.
Ken forgot to record us.
You guys are handy.
Hit the start button.
Yeah, it will. It'll pick us up, but it doesn't come through the board. So all it would hear is fucking Mike over here going.
Blah 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 blah
blah blah blah blah blah.
Hey, try not to shoot that puck up my hooper. Yeah, but check out this guy.
I swear, I just heard this.
He says I'll shoot the puck anywhere I want, and if that happens to be in your hooper, so be it.
Yes, we always hear you.
Because I can't. It pops in my mic, my headphones. So I had to turn it way down.
You got the fucking cheap headphones.
They're not cheap, but
they're Bose. I got batteries in them. They're Bose.
The batteries.
On Jeff Hackett, low to the stick side. Great individual effort.
And now from the hockey capital of the world, Park Ridge, Illinois. It's the Bacon and Hockey Podcast. And now,
Black Mike.
Here he is, the hockey man with the plan, that bacon frying fool, your host, Jack.
From deep underground, the broadcast bunker, once again, I am Jack. And with me always is Sexy Terry.
Hello.
Thank you. Thank you.
We're interrupting him.
I was going to do it.
He's playing Angry Birds. Professor Ken.
Giddy up, good listener.
Doing Stack the States.
Stack the States. And, of course, rookie Mike.
Oh, buenos dias.
Sailor Dan's on assignment, but he should be here any moment. Well, we're back, and we have our rookie Mike back from the glorious Caribbean. What's that?
We got him back from the glorious
Yes, welcome back.
More importantly, he's finally drinking again.
He's drinking, and glad to have you, buddy.
Glad to have you drinking again.
Yeah. I was much more coherent when I was not drinking.
Yes.
But we love you when you're drinking, Mikey.
Well, we're back, and we have four new Twitter followers. None of them look like porn this time.
Oh, damn it.
That's nice. Scott Thompson follows us. Hockey coach follows us. And Christine something or another follows us. And
thank you all of our new Twitter.
Yes,
is that Terry's wife?
No.
And another tweet from Lexi Carmichael.
It would just be dislike.
Yes. Lexi Carmichael tweets. Oh
Jesus Christ. Just trying to fight through the stuff early, gentlemen.
Yeah.
Just trying to make sure that we're ready.
This is our first podcast ever.
It's right.
I tried out before the show. Everything works great. And then I go to do it and the fucking shit don't work.
Yeah, it sounded great beforehand.
Yeah.
But anyway, we got a tweet from Lexi Carmichael. It's a picture of a car vent that says email and bacon. I don't know how to describe it other than it's like the vent of an air conditioner in a car.
I get it.
Yeah, the bottom part. It looks like bacon. It just means flowing air, and the other one is blocked up. I don't know if you can see. Kenny, you should know because
that's
I'm
great.
Pretty sure you
slow
see.
Down.
No, bring it on.
Slow your shit down.
All right, Mike, it's 9:18.
Slow your roll.
We can start drinking the whiskey.
Yes.
Are we going to wait for this guy?
No.
Fuck him.
No, screw Dan.
All right, well, I got a bottle.
Dan. Oh, wait a minute. Wait.
Okay. Well, here's some shot glasses then.
No, fuck this. I went all out, man.
Rookie Mike came
He brought his daughter's his lunch bag.
This. He's got a purple lunch bag. He's got
ice.
He's got ice.
Wow.
We're going to have some Dominican Republic rum.
All right. Let's take a look at that. Wow. Look at that.
That's not going to last very long.
Well, look at this. I figure this is all I can fit my.
Ladies and gentlemen, it looks like a bottle with like.
What about up your ass?
You keistered. He keistered it.
Yeah, you could have brought a few bottles.
I got a Dominican Republic cigar.
All right.
Leon
Jimenez.
Leon, I drink a lot with Leon Jimenez.
Oh yeah, thanks, buddy.
It's supposed to be on the mild side.
Michael, welcome back.
Welcome back. You know what? I take back all the stuff Terry said about you while you were gone.
Wow, look at that.
You guys want to try the rum? I figure rum on the rocks better than this.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, I do.
I'll take rum.
I'll take a little rum.
Kenny?
Hell yeah.
Wow, thanks,
bud. This doesn't smell like your ass at all.
Well, a little bit. That's how I got it back in there. I had to put it on the cavity.
That smells fantastic.
Keistered it.
You watch? Have you seen Get Hard?
My hands are clean, just so you know.
Do you think that bothered
but
us?
But the table's not.
That's all right.
There's nothing clean about this table.
Dominican rum, yeah, it's got like a fishnet stocking kind of fishnetting around it.
Show it to the audience.
There, we'll sure take it.
Rugal.
We'll post it on
this
the...
This is the top notch, the special reserve.
Oh, man, nothing but the best for us. But of course, terrific.
How do you get this shit out of here?
It's got like a plastic
got a
thing
on
top.
On it.
Oh, there you go. Wow, that's a tall pour you got there. Oh, thank you, Terry. How's ooh?
Oh, very nice.
It looks terrific.
I had to leave two pairs of shoes down here to get the booze and the cigars back.
Wow,
very nice cigar.
Here, you guys.
That is tasty. Thank you, Mike. So what did you do down there? Just relax on the beach?
We went to the beach one day.
Very good.
Sat down by the pool. Just sat there. Didn't do anything to drink. Then we became friends with the swim-up bartender. And we didn't realize this until a little bit into the trip where we were giving him... We did a conversion on our phone, pesos. Well, we didn't realize there's Dominican pesos and there's
Mexican pesos.
So we looked at the exchange rate and we gave him a thousand peso or $1,000 bill or whatever. We thought it was like $5. Well, we find out it was actually $22.
Mm. Oh, so he was your best friend after that.
That's how we spend each day.
That's how you do it, though. That's how you...
Every time he came up, there's a little group. He's like, amigo, amigo. And then he'd give us our drink, and he'd give us the higher stuff. And then he'd give us shots with him, and then we'd do shots with him. For $22.
I got to say, $22
is that's pretty damn cheap.
That's a steal.
They say to do that all the time. When you roll into a place the very first time, you drop down a giant fucking tip, and you can leave a little something after that, but they'll always remember you.
Yeah, and then, I mean, do it up front, because then they're always going to be looking for you.
All right.
So, you guys try
Let's try it. Cheers, boys.
Cheers. So... I'm not a big rum guy, but this is very good.
It's good rum.
Cheers. I'll tell you what, I like that Seeker, though.
Ooh.
Not bad.
Dominican Republic.
It's not spicy rum, which is, I don't like spicy rum.
No, this is like what pirates drink, rum. That's good.
I got this from a pirate.
I wish I had a pirate. I don't have an arr.
You better look for one.
What
the fuck is a cutter?
This one over here.
It just cuts the nipple off.
You need the Yo-Ho song from the Pirates of the Caribbean.
Do you have one, full through one?
What do you need?
Here. Thank you, Mike.
You're welcome.
Thanks a lot, Mikey boy. Delish. I feel like I'm in the Caribbean.
I smoked my Jimenez already. I had to go to my own reserve.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, these are very, very, very good.
Are they smooth?
Yeah.
Yeah. I know when we were down in Mexico and I'd go over to the island, and whether you were getting fake Cubans or not, just sitting out there, you know, part of it's just a slower.
Well, you know what? It's all part just not being at home.
Did you see the video I saw?
Not being at work.
But the cigars are, you know, sitting out there and they really taste
good. Yeah. With Kenny?
Yeah.
Yeah. Can I get that lighter?
Look at that little stubby thing.
Wow, it's another.
You must be confident in your manhood.
Speaking of confident in your manhood, Kenny was teaching a class tonight, and he told us he was for something from work, but I'm pretty sure it was one of those personal growth classes at the Discovery Center.
So the Texas today, they were very, very entertaining.
And so I get out of the class. It's consulting boot camp, and all of us, all consultants.
It was macrame
supposed to go.
Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, Sailor Dan's here. Dan, take your seat at the bridge.
Oh, yeah.
And I bought the vomit protection on it.
I got to pod your ass up.
Pod him up. Ladies and gentlemen, Sailor Dan is here.
So I go to Guitar Center today, and I bought the mic and I bought the stand. And the guy's trying to talk me into the $5.
Hold on.
The $5 insurance for 2 years, and I actually asked him, is it vom? Does it include vomit? And he kind of looks at me funny. He's like, well, I guess so. I'm like, well, I'll take it.
Yes, yes, vomit.
So
vomit.
Dan, you can throw up all you want on
vomit
that,
at
on
will,
that,
my friend. Vomit at will.
Does it work?
No.
Yeah.
No, it doesn't. Yeah.
It's a fake one.
It's a fake mic. In.
No, it works. You just got to get up in there.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's what he said.
Yeah. No, a little closer. A little closer, Dan.
Okay.
I left my cutter here last time.
It's probably over here somewhere.
That's not it.
No. Mike has one.
Is this it?
Dan, I don't know if you know this or not, but we have a podcast going right now, and
you're more than welcome to join us.
Yeah, it's
you can sit down and put a set of headphones on if you want,
or we can all take off our headphones and search for your fucking cutter.
Cranky, yeah. Listen, you would have thought his primal scream therapy class he took would make him feel better after coming back, but Kenny's all cranky and
consulting boot camp. Wrong, I'm trying to take it over. Jeez. You got to eat that.
Very nice.
You got to eat
that. I like.
You got your headphones?
Let him get his headphones on, Kenny.
I can't even turn him up any louder than he speaks so quietly.
There you go.
Let's hear it for the first time.
Can you
hear me? Oh, yeah! Yes!
Oh, yeah.
What's up, y'all?
It's the Night Ranger. How's everybody doing tonight?
Sailor Dan, here. Sexy pipes.
Yes.
Sailor Dan here to take you through the midnight hour.
Here's a little Baby Come Back by Ambrosia for you. Hope you enjoy it.
Baby Come Back.
Good for morning. You lovers out there.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes.
So, Dan, welcome to the show officially with the mic. And, Mike, welcome back.
Cheers.
Yeah, more importantly, Mikey's drinking.
Making me feel welcome.
Of course.
Oh, you're always welcome here.
And call me a dick for being late. I appreciate that.
Why were you late?
That nice shit down here. Look at the cost.
I left work late, and I had to go to Muller Honda and buy a car.
Oh.
So I just got through that whole experience.
Oh, that's always fun, huh?
Yeah. Well, I kind of do that shit all day at work, so, you know.
Buy cars.
Buy cars at work?
No, not cars. I negotiate.
I thought you were in the restaurant.
I'm a buyer, so.
I know.
And, you know, this guy's a rookie. And
so what you get?
A Honda Odyssey.
That's...
Boy, isn't that made by a Mercedes?
The Cadillac. Isn't that what you have, a sexy Terry?
No, we have a Nissan Quest.
Okay.
God.
You know you're old and you have kids whenever you go to a car dealer and you look at the minivans before you look at a sports car.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know, originally she wanted a Pilot. We have a minivan now, a Dodge. Right?
She can't drive herself.
Well,
she's a pilot.
Boom! I got it.
Boom!
She just doesn't want the minivan, but the Pilot's not going to work. There's five of us, and we go on a trip, and
yeah,
you know, there's nothing wrong with the minivan.
You ever thought about birth control?
I got to tell you, yeah.
Then you don't have to buy such.
I like my minivan. I used to hate it, and now I love it. I have to admit it. I kind of dig it.
And the Odyssey compared, because we had a Dodge Caravan before. The Odyssey's
it's beautiful.
It's nice. I mean, you know. It's like,
well, even with the Quest, we put the seats down. We could fit the 4x8 sheets of plywood in back.
Yeah.
Oh.
not that I ever do it, but in case you need it, it's there.
I just bought 15, 2x4x8s, and now Kenny called me the other day, and I put a bunch of lumber in the back of that thing, and it's great.
You've been part of Van Talk.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. It's Minivan Talk.
Good morning, everybody.
The car when you just given up.
Yeah.
Everyone must own one.
Yeah. Oh, there's nothing wrong with a minivan.
I actually like it. And if you go camping and stuff like that,
Ken,
it's
look
great.
Who's talking. The two guys that own one. I'm just at a party. Fuck that.
It's like, no, balding is fine. I think I feel more mature.
Yeah.
You all should try it.
Do you need a little more room there, Danny boy?
You know, I don't know if these headphones are plugged in. I can't tell.
You got the
can
power
you hear,
turned on?
Can you hear us?
Can you follow the cord through there, Mike? You know what? If you would have showed up before the show, we could have teched all this out.
Yeah.
Preds Discord.
Uh-oh.
Oh, and I got Pecorine. I got Pecorine starting tonight there, Mike.
On what?
Hey, is this him here?
Is he plugged in over here?
Where is...
Well, you know what?
What the fuck's he looking at?
Dan, you want to follow your
He's
record?
Lighting his seat.
Dan, anytime you want to join the show.
It's like my daughter.
Oh.
No, I think I'm fine because when you played the music, I heard it fine.
Oh, can you hear this?
Yeah.
Then you just need
to
pop it down there.
Have you tried a Q-tip?
Which one is him? you know, I have to tell you a story, and this is a Navy story, too. And I was on a ship maybe 2 weeks, and I was having some ear trouble. And they sent me up to medical, and they said I had a wax problem. And the guy, and he's like a E4 petty officer, young medical guy.
Is that better?
Yeah, it's fine. Yeah, no, that is better. Thanks.
Okay. Got it. You start, Scarlett.
Engineer Mike and Engineer Jack to the rescue. No
starts
problem.
Digging in my ear. And flushing it out with water, like really hard. It kind of hurt. And there was a piece of wax, probably the size of a, maybe half the size of a marble.
Wow.
And I swear to God, and we're out to sea at this point.
I can hear it now. I feel like I'm there.
I mean,
it's like
know,
it's like a shelter here.
I could hear a merchant ship.
Off
like,
the coast of Benghazi, 1983.
50 miles away, you know.
It wasn't wax, it was an ear plug. It was just lodged in there.
I could hear so well. I could hear everything after that.
Wow.
Well,
it's a miracle.
I was good?
Yeah, that's a great story.
Take that mic away.
Thanks.
you want to pot him down a little bit.
Thanks, sir, Dan. It's 30 seconds. We can't get back to our lives. Hey, I was watching the last week, I think was the first episode of Survivor, and this girl was on there, and she was having, she thought something crawled in her ear. She was having a problem with her ear, and it was driving her, absolutely batty.
Yeah.
And she was about ready to quit after, you know, a couple of days.
Yeah.
The camera happened to actually be there when you saw the fucking worm crawl out of the ear. And one of the guys grabbed it. But she was like, her ear was bleeding. It was like eating the inside of her eardrum-ish. Not that far, probably. But
oh, my God.
Yeah, that's bad. That shit can get
you. I would have quit. I'd say, you know what? I quit.
I'm done.
That's why they call them earwigs.
Yeah, great. Thanks, Lance. It's ear
talk. It's ear talk.
Ear talk, ladies and gentlemen.
Earwigs, is that anything like a
Hey,
Dan, can you still hear this?
Yeah.
Oh, you're fine.
I can hear that. What are those audio tests? Yes, 3-1.
That's right.
Ooh.
3-1, ladies and gentlemen. The Hawks are losing again.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
It's going to... 20 seconds left?
After the great showing they put on national TV?
What the frick happened there?
I don't know if any... Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I don't know if you caught the fantastic Stadium Series game where they were shellacked by the Minnesota Wild in Minnesota.
They looked horrible.
You know what? They just looked bored, and they didn't look... They looked like they didn't want to be there.
Yeah, it didn't look good.
Crawford's gear looked good.
It was kind of like Mike when he wasn't drinking on the podcast.
You guys know what the record of the Hawks in any of the outdoor games?
It's 1-6, right?
1-3.
1-3, yeah.
Only been in 4 games?
They beat Pittsburgh.
They were at the
here.
Game I was at, the Soldier Field game.
And they beat the crap out of Pittsburgh, which was nice. I liked it. It was like a snowy game, too. Yeah. My America's Wang was at that game. And
I was in Soldier Field, right?
Yeah. Yes. My brother America's Wang, hopefully he said he was going to call in and get his friends to call in, too, with live...
They lost to Detroit when I saw them in Wrigley.
Yeah.
But they gave us these cool, and you freaking need it. These outdoor games are all just for the people want to go once. They gave us these little binoculars, and they give them to you for a freaking reason. And then you can't see. You saw my post.
What's the reason?
You can't see. You're a fucking mile away. And then the other bad part about it is you're down lower, you know, at least in the UC where my tickets are, which I'm going on Sunday, are way the fuck up there. So
yeah, you
got
the whole ice.
Yeah.
You
get out in center field of Wrigley, and they were playing in the infield, and you had the boards. You could see all of, you know, a half the ice.
Yeah.
And my post was, how about some clear boards on these outside games so we could see the fucking puck?
And then the players won't be able to see where they're going and run right in the boards.
Yeah.
Well, the best seat,
right
the best seat for the outdoor games is right on your couch.
I agree. Yeah.
Or on Kenny's couch.
Sorry, Kenny.
Sexy Terry came
in
over.
In this case, not at all on any couch.
Kenny and I watched the first period. We were like, fuck this. So we started playing Golden Tee.
I turned the shit off.
And I kicked Kenny's ass at Golden Tee again. Again.
We tied the last game. And I gave out. I had you by 5 strokes.
Oh, you're so full of shit.
Were you playing Golden what?
Golden Tee.
Golden Tee.
Golden Shower.
That golf game?
Yeah. Golden Showers. They're giving each other
Well, Dan, if you would have went to Kenny's house, I did invite you.
You can see.
Even though it was Kenny's house, I invited you.
I was out of peanut butter, you know.
Oh, with those two giant dogs?
Golden yeah. tee. It's see who can balance a golf ball in their penis longer.
What? Write it down.
And
mark it down.
I won.
Because your penis is flatter on the end
yes.
than his is.
Yes.
It's from doing this on Kenny.
Or one of them's not shake circumcised weight. And they got the
the shake
the
weight.
Sheave. The sheave.
Well, they got their ass kicked. Is there any? How's the phone call situation there, Kenny?
I think we got a couple, Jackie.
Should we check it out?
I did not check the voice level on this, but let's see what happens. This is one here. Play message. Mm-hmm. Let's see here. It's thinking.
Yeah.
This is really good.
Hey, Bacon and Acme Podcast here at the Rockford IceHogs versus the Chicago Wolves, where the Rockford IceHogs are up 2-1 over your Chicago Wolves.
Hey.
We're first intermission.
It's the AHL report from Professor Ken. So you drove all the way to Rockford.
I don't
even
know what happened at the end of that because it says on here, it says we're in the first intermission. F asterisk asterisk U later. Bye bye. Because it translates it for you on here.
Hey.
I went to the Hogs game.
That's
the Wolves game.
Yeah, I went to see the Hogs.
You drove out the. How is the Rockford ice?
No, it was here in Rosemont.
I'll tell you the one.
Oh,
comment.
You went here.
Lori made a comment because good old number 44 in your playbook, Brian Bickle, was playing.
He's 44 down there?
She looks at him and she says, I think he actually got worse down there. But he was like one of the faster guys on the ice. So
really?
That just goes to show you
why,
what the talent is down
there.
Why
did he drop that
there.
Number?
Somebody else was already 24, and I wonder if...
29.
Yeah. I don't know if there was a 29. I think somebody already had 29, but I don't know why
but
he didn't wrestle it from
him. Don't you automatically get it?
Well, and he's making millions. All he had to do was say, hey, I'll flip you $5,000 and give it to me. And I'm like, okay.
He probably fought for it. He lost.
Yeah. Yeah, right.
So I got
you know what? I give Brian Bickle all the credit in the world. He made his fortune.
Yeah. And
by being at the right place at the right time.
And
he wasn't very good.
He scored a couple of crucial goals during this finals.
Oh,
so.
Yeah, it was big. That's what got him the money.
Yeah.
He was the poor man's Dustin Byfuglien for a year.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't work out. See what we got here.
What else we got, Kenny?
That's got to be the worst feeling.
Whoever left this one didn't leave anything.
You know, he's got his name on the cup.
No, but imagine knowing that the team that you were with, you're still on that organization.
Organization.
Wait.
Yeah, but you're sent down
he's
to play in Rockford.
I'm going to have to crank him up.
Have you guys been to Rockford before?
I drove through it.
Yeah. You don't want to play in Rockford.
Very fast.
I worked in Rockford.
I've been to Beefaroo. I like that. Beefaroo's
good.
That's the best part.
Beefaroo is terrific.
I think I've been to the Cracker Barrel there.
Did you ever go to Top Hat, Mike?
Top Hat where?
In Rockford. A restaurant there near McChesney.
That's McChesney. That's not Rockford.
Let's see what we got.
I went to, there's an old Italian place.
McChesney, Arkansas.
There's an old Italian place that's not there anymore that I went to, and it was pretty good. In Rockford.
Yeah. There's Lino's is really good. Have you ever been there?
I don't know.
Francesca's is really good.
Was it Francesca's in Rockford?
Was it the Olive Garden?
Not yet.
Francesca's good.
Francesca's is great.
Very good.
I liked it better when it was the old one by the mall.
We should have our annual banquet there at Francesca's, the end of season banquet.
Are we talking about the same thing?
You're listening to Rockford Talk here on Easy 103.
What's next?
Hello, boys. This is America's Wang calling you from the state of hockey, Minneapolis.
That's a say.
Oop, I think he had trouble on that one.
Oh, he got eaten.
I think he did, but he left another one. I think he got cut off. Let's see what he says here. Oh, this is a big one.
It was mild, so that's why I was...
Oh, these are really good.
Hello, Bacon and Hockey. This is America's Wang calling you from the state of hockey in Minneapolis, Minnesota, and... Today is Sunday. This is the actual date of the NHL game between the Minnesota Wild and the Chicago Blackhawks. Yesterday's game, the alumni game versus the Chicago Blackhawks alumni organization and the former North Stars of Minnesota, was it was a show. It was a spectacle. It was absolutely cute and adorable the entire way. And watching, a 40, 50-year-old gentleman who used to be goalies trying to do butterfly saves is not necessarily the best thing you want to see without alcohol. Probably the best scene in the house was, for me, watching Troy Murray actually make a penalty shot off of a... all penalties, by the way, became penalty shots, which was interesting. The game itself is fun. We have some amazingly loud, powerfully interesting Minnesota Wild fan neighbors that you will hear later today when I call again. But we will talk to you soon, and go Blackhawks.
You know, it was pretty
cool. Thank you, Wang.
The Minnesota goalie was pretty damn good in that
Don
alumni
Beaupre?
Game. Yeah.
Don Beaupre was a great goalie when he played.
But
he played well. I mean,
Belfour looked terrible.
Belfour. And it was Jimmy Waite, and it was it wasn't Belfour. It was
we were up at
It was Murray Bannerman.
Murray Bannerman. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. He was horrible. We got another one here.
More. Let's go.
More
content.
We should maybe spread these out over
Shame.
A few.
Nah, just put them off.
Hello, boys. It is America's Way.
He's drinking.
The state of hockey, Minneapolis, Minnesota, at the Stadium Series game versus.
It's about 3 hours later.
And I am surrounded by a bipartisan crowd. It's a pretty good mix of both. And we're going to have Live Cheap Trick in a little while. We're going to have Soul Asylum. I don't know who the hell they are. And we're, of course, going to have an amazing amount of hockey. I have had more than my share of Bloody Marys and maybe a little beer on the side. So I think I'm in the right spirit of the season. And even, we've got some rowdy people that are after me. And I think we're going to have some excellent hockey in a little while here. And hopefully we'll be talking to you in a little bit. All right, boys. It's even starting to snow a little bit, so we're in the right season for the day.
Oh, I can't wait for the next call.
And I'll talk to you in a little while. No hockey. Bye, boys.
He sounds
I'll read this sentence here because it translates the message in here.
Yeah.
It says, I've had more than my share of Bloody Marys and maybe a little bit on the side Tony Lewis period of the season. And anyway, yeah, we got some brownies people here, her address. And I don't
Kirby Puckett's in the house.
And I don't have some excellent hockey a little while here.
That's awesome.
God.
Well done, boy.
Thank you, Wang.
He's got another one here. He's not done. It's the Wang Show.
Hold tight.
Hello, boys. It's Chris again calling from the state of hockey in Minnesota. At the end of two, with 25 penalty minutes on the board, the Blackhawks are, in fact, down 0-4. And it looks like there was one major injury. There was an interference and misconduct from Roosevelt. So I believe Zucker from the Minnesota Wild are out. It's otherwise been a great day. We even had some decent snow. We saw Chief Trick a little while ago. And the beer is and the vodka is fading, so I may at some point have to get a little bit more. But otherwise, we're having a lovely day despite the score. All right, talk to you soon. Bye.
He is talking faster and faster each phone call.
So this one is, hello, boys. It's Chris again calling from the state of hockey in Minnesota at the end of June with 2,500 units on the board. The Blackhawks are, in fact, down is 3,000 to 4.
That may as well have been 3,000 to 4.
And it looks like there was one major injury, and there was interference and misconduct from Rose, and also, I believe, the soccer from the Minnesota Wild around. And otherwise, have a great day and even had some due snow. Is Cheap Trick in a little while ago. Blah, blah, blah. It doesn't translate very well.
Speaking of that hit, that Roosevelt hit was not a misconduct.
That was they
got robbed.
He didn't
that was
leave.
Terrible.
He did not do anything. I mean,
the officiating was terrible in that game.
Terrible.
Absolutely.
I don't think it would have affected the outcome, but it was just really bad.
They looked like they didn't care.
That's what I said earlier.
Who cares?
I thought Dan was the one that came late. Where the hell were you? Repeating what Terry says.
Yeah, all right. Is that it?
That was it.
All right.
That was it.
Good job, America's Wang.
Good job. Oh.
Yeah, no, we got to.
I guess news today, right? Andrew Ladd.
Oh, I just got a text back from the America's Wang saying, glad you liked him. I was too bummed and pissed off to give anything more, but the game was awesome to watch.
That was great.
We understand.
Tell Chris, thank you.
Oh, that's awesome.
His name's Chris. That was America's Wang.
No, his name is actually always, no. Chris is his nickname. His name is actually America's Wang.
Yeah. That's what I thought.
America's Wang.
But I go by Chris.
America's Wang was a family friend that my parents wanted to, name him after. So.
Did you say you had some news, Mike?
No, none. Just the trade.
Okay, I take it back.
So we got Ladd. Who did we get rid of?
Dano, in a first round.
Marco Dano.
We had two first
draft
rounds.
I heard one.
Two. First round.
Two is steep.
2016 first round draft pick. 2017 or 18 conditional draft pick. And then we got three guys from them. We got Frazier, who's a defenseman, and some other guy.
Yeah, but they're going right to Rockford.
Right to Rockford.
They're going to be line mates with Bickle.
Based on what I saw, they could use him.
Do we need Ladd?
I
like Ladd.
I don't know. What was his infatuation with getting a left winger?
I don't think it would hurt to have him, but I can't imagine that he's, he's kind of long in the tooth.
But they need someone. They're thinking this is going to be like the Vermette thing last year, where Vermette just turned it on.
I'd rather have Vermette.
Well, I don't think that's an option right now, but. They need someone on that top line.
But it almost seems like bringing Versteeg back last year, which I don't think did anything for the team.
No. Quantaville's in love with Versteeg, though. He played him a shitload.
Quantaville.
Quantico?
Quantico, the.
Jesus.
Our coach, Guantanamo Bay.
I like Ladd.
He's great, but
we'll see what happens.
He's the top line of Winnipeg, and that's about as good as you can say. He's our captain.
I got a question for you. Do they like left-handers on the left wing, or is it the opposite way? Do you want a right-hander on the left wing and a left-hander?
Opposite.
Yeah.
You want a left-hander on the right
wing?
Yeah,
because you want an inside shot.
Right.
That's why you always see Kane's a left-handed shot, and he's always on the right hand.
I never remember that he is, and when I watch him shoot sometimes,
I played left wing when I played water polo, Kenny.
Yeah, that's the toughest sport in the world
to
play,
it is.
Perry.
Thank you for bringing up that point.
That's like number one.
Yes, it is.
90% of the game is under the plate, under the water, and you don't know what happens under there.
Toughest game in the
bunch
world.
Bunch of fucking homos. The reason why it's tough is because you're playing with each other's nutsack.
A lot of cock punching.
Terry showed up and said, what can I wear a Speedo and headgear play a sport? Yeah. And it's like, the only thing we have is
water polo. I'm in.
Do you know why they
I want to cross wrestling and swimming.
You know why they have face masks on the water polo helmets, don't you? So they can't suck each other's dick.
Yeah. Hey, I worked my way around that one, too.
Yeah, he's like Hannibal Lecter. He's the only guy with a cage on.
Hello, Cleese.
Until the locker room.
All right. Well,
what's funny is both teams dressed in the same locker.
I had the mask with the zipper.
You had the tearaway.
The leather mask with the zipper.
Go, Dan.
I would just like to say that both my boys will be playing water polo.
Good men. You mean your men? Both of your men will be playing water polo.
Make sure they're like Terry. Play with a cup. And if you get one that's inflatable, it helps you float.
Yeah. But here's the shitty part: is that they're playing in Oak Park at a
pool
at like 7 in the morning on Saturdays.
We're at Oak Park
at a pool.
It's the high school.
Fenwick.
Fenwick, yeah.
Is that Fenwick in Oak Park?
Yeah, it's a small pool too.
Oh, but you would know.
They're like water polo titans, right? Fenwick.
Oh yeah. Oh,
you send your kids to Fenwick.
Hey, sit down. Let me tell you about the fucking St. Pat's water polo.
That's
team,
right,
pal. Back in the 70s and 80s, they were number one in the country.
Don't mess with St. Pat's. That's water polo talk, ladies and gentlemen.
Our listeners are just enthralled.
We have no listeners, Dan. Yeah. Who the hell cares?
You kidding me? We might turn a couple to water polo.
So I actually showed my kids the video from last week's show for about the first 10 seconds. And Michael, he looks at me, he's like, Uncle Ken looks homeless.
Yep.
Oh, is this being filmed? You see, I don't like that stuff.
you're the best looking guy here, Dan.
That's why you have it on the end.
You're the face of the show right now.
You got the biggest nose out of all of us, so we want you facing straight on. We don't want to catch you in the profile.
The best thing, if you actually look at it, we're not even in the picture.
Yeah,
I zoomed in on Dan.
It's zoomed right to you.
Trying to attract the 45 to 50 female crowd or something.
That's right. Well, that's our demographic, Dan. Yeah.
Yes, anybody, if you could attract two people, that's fine with us.
Yeah.
I picked up a listener this week, which scares the hell out of me because the work is the last.
What
place.
On the side of the road?
Roger, who is an ex sailor, also Dan. Maybe you turned him onto the show, but he went home and I saw that we had a like on the Facebook page and. Mm-hmm. So I would imagine this could be maybe one of his first episodes that he listens to. Welcome, Roger.
All right.
So, did you guys like have a moment on Facebook or what?
We did. We touched
Kenny, helmets. Kenny's like, hey, you want to meet?
We touched
coffee.
No,
yeah. Yeah.
It wasn't Facebook. Yeah. It was Grindr.
.com.
Right. Oh, man.
Hey, guys, buddy.
Hey, there's a rest area around 20 miles from my house.
You know, the rest areas are the homosexual hangouts of the 2000s.
Yeah, I'll be tapping my foot.
It was that something about Mary.
Kick him out wide.
Oh, boy. Well, America's Wang just texted me. He's going to go to a Ducks game.
Mikey,
these are very good. Yeah,
these
are very good.
When you have a good one, you know, and even the ones that you bring, you know, are pretty nice. But man, when you get one from down south like that, it's like, wow, these are what cigars are supposed
to
be.
It's like nice and tight, and you know, I mean,
it's like your first girlfriend.
Wow, what the fuck was that?
Is that Dan's phone?
Yeah. Oh my god, that was loud.
That's my text.
I like that.
Okay,
hey, Irish Spring boy.
I like that. Kenny nailed that.
That's Old Spice, isn't it? That's Old Spice.
Yeah, that's my son asking if I could drive him to school early tomorrow.
Oh, to play water polo? Is he studying?
You know, he's a straight A guy. He always wants to go in early to. I mean,
good for him.
I gotta take the kids every day at 7.
We can make fun of him on the show, but don't let him hear it. Because good for him.
No, it's. I mean, I think there's a restriction that he can't.
Good. Yes.
Oh, listen.
Explicit material. Yeah. Yeah,
I do list it as such. Yeah. I do list it as such. The only box I don't check is
actually my kids
violent.
My kids listen once. They're like, nah, we're not going to listen again.
Guys, I don't think it really has a lot to offer them.
You guys are idiots. Oh, come on.
What kind of parent are you? Actually, they were on the show a couple times.
Yeah, we had usually
when the German girls were here, I think.
That's right. One of the German girls coming back.
Not soon enough.
They're coming soon. Sorry. It's coming soon from Deutschland with love.
Speaking of which, I think we picked up another country this week.
Oh, yeah?
We're up there.
Wasn't Dominica, I can tell you that.
No, I think it.
They don't have phones down there.
Yeah.
They don't have the internet.
They don't have the internet. None of them.
What country, Kenny?
I think it might have been Sweden.
Sweden, all right, welcome.
Yeah, there we go.
Thank you, Sweden.
Sweden, that's a good
Chalmerson's family.
At least it's
Kruger's
a
family.
That's a hockey country, at least. Thank goodness. Welcome, Swedish listeners.
They probably were waiting for us to talk about who the hell's from
the bikini team.
Who the hell was from Sweden?
Half our damn
Chalmerson,
team.
Kruger's
the
Rasmussen.
One I was thinking of because they always wear the
When's
real skinny
he coming
jeans.
Back?
He's skating right now.
That's good to hear.
But
well, how many Swedish players are on the Blackhawks? I mean,
the whole defense,
like
all
a bunch. Yeah, I mean we have like there's a couple of new guys like
Rasmussen.
Who's the other big tall bald guy?
Oh, Svedberg.
Svedberg, yeah.
He's got to be from there, huh?
Yeah, I think there's a whole
geography.
You want me to look it up, Jack?
Look it up there, Mikey.
Beep boop beep boop.
Oh, I got that. Hang on 1 second. Where is that? Yep, I got that, Mike.
Hang on.
What are you doing? Go to the interwebs.
Yeah. Swedd. Nope. Delete. DENN. Delete. Enter. There it is.
Let Kenny type it. It'll come up like dong or something.
I swear to God, even when I try to do right, it
Dan,
fucking
I was so
words.
Proud of you today when you said, "Is that English?"
Now he's learning. He's learning.
Well, I mean, I just couldn't understand it. I mean.
Thank you. Kenny, welcome to our world.
I think Kenny even posted something on Facebook that translated weird. And you had to go back.
I mean,
edit
usually
it.
You can kind of okay. I see what he was going.
No,
through,
you have.
I had no clue.
Literally, you have to look at whatever he types. Look at the keys around it because he just hit the wrong one.
It's like the Enigma code in World War II. You have to kind of figure it out. You've broken
like code talkers like the
wind talkers.
Yeah. You don't have the software, the deciphering software in your phone yet. That's the next step.
We have the
Professor Cipher.
Yeah.
So we have Eric Gustafson, Hammer,
yeah,
Kruger,
yeah,
Rasmussen,
yeah,
Victor Svedberg.
Oh, that's a lot of Swedes. Yeah. That's a lot of Swedes.
That's a handful of Swedes right there.
I bought some Fontina cheese from Sweden this week.
Is that where it comes from?
Well, it can come from Italy. It can come from other places. First time I've had Swedish Fontina.
How is it?
It was pretty good.
Not How many Americans do the Hawks have on their team?
All right, let's think about this. Besides Kane? That would be... Well, Saad was, but he's not anymore. That's it. That's all I can think of.
Oh, it just came?
Wait a minute. Oh, no. Trevor Van Riemsdyk's is
one
he's
more.
An American.
Wait a minute.
And that would be... Yes, ladies and gentlemen, let's think about this for a second.
Oh, what about the Darling?
Darling, ladies and gentlemen.
From Lamont.
Lamont's own Darling. How could I have forgotten him?
Wasn't he like a drug addict and stuff?
Drunk.
That's it.
He was a drunk.
I thought it was drugs.
Who's that? Booze, Darling.
I thought it was the drugs.
But it could be.
Probably some drugs. But then he gave a guy like a month's rent and some other stuff. He just sort of some guy he met when you heard that story, right?
Yeah, it was a cab, right?
I don't think so.
What do you mean you don't think so?
I don't think I've heard it.
Oh, you haven't heard the story?
No, I've never heard it.
Yeah. No, he was like, was it in Arizona maybe or something?
He was in a cab.
He's had like three chances and he's.
Oh yeah, but just recently he like was at a game and he met some guy who was having some trouble or something. Was it?
And he paid for his hotel or something like
that. Yeah, he paid for his hotel for like a month, and then he gave him some money to get him because he was like having a rough time or whatever. And he didn't even say anything about it. And it's finally somebody leaked out like, hey, you know, Darling, just like help some poor dude out and stuff. So he's a good guy, ladies and gentlemen.
Applause,
oh, thank you.
Applause.
Uh-oh. Biscuits are done.
Well, let me know where he hangs out then.
Yeah, no kidding.
Yeah, I'm kind of down on my luck.
Because I'm down on my luck. I'm about to be down to one household income, which is not going to be good. Mike, you did keister this. It's dented and shit.
Well, his anus.
I tried to take a label off. Simmer down. And it was.
Oh, you didn't want us to know that it was a buck?
He took it off the hard way.
Thank you, Mike.
Is that Cuban?
No, it's Dominican.
Oh, well, then you don't have to worry about it.
No, but I just didn't want to.
It's fun to keister at that.
Don't have to put it up your ass.
He claimed that he was bringing back $5 in tobacco, and he had like a case of cigars.
Did you smoke any Cuban something?
I did not. It was all Dominican.
He was with his wife.
Hey, Dominican cigars are darn good. Well, I'm enjoying the hell out of this cigar, Mikey boy.
I'll tell you what, if that cigar gets any bigger, you can smoke me.
Jesus. All right.
Jesus. you know
just the way you said macro.
Back in the day, back in the day when you lost signal, you used to have that cross hatch. Like
no, the Indian.
Yes, the Indian test pattern. Yes.
Mike, you have any more?
We're experiencing technical difficulties. We'll be right back. Oh, is there more of that? Oh, that is good.
There's not a lot of it here.
I'll do Jake.
I'll have a
yeah, you will.
Again?
I'm ready. I'll take it.
Is there anything left at all? I keep going back for more.
Also,
just give me that. This one has the tiniest of tastes. Just a.
So that's why I drink
that's
all
good,
week.
That's good. Good. I just wanted a little taste. That's...
I'll just finish it.
Don't these guys want some?
No.
Oh, then give it to me.
Well,
what about you? Here, pour some.
No, that's good. Dan, do you have any?
I did. It was awesome. I like rum.
I do too, especially like
so
good dark.
So I took your advice. I said I want the best.
See that bottle.
Dark rum. Splash of soda water, which they didn't understand what fuck.
Ooh, Brugal. I've had
so
this rum before.
They just gave me water, and then they don't have lemons. They don't know lemons and limes are the same thing to them.
Yeah,
right. So it was lemon and lime. Excuse me.
Did I make you pee, Terry?
No, I got a little.
You can take that outside.
Took off the block.
Yeah, it's not good. I was watching the video from last week.
What?
And it's like
you can't even see us right now.
Oh, we're like in. Why don't you crack the garage door?
Yeah, if you crack that and crack the other one, then you have two cracks.
Just crack it.
Crack it. That's good.
Now how am I gonna try to filter that out?
What?
Garage door opening.
Oh, you doing?
You actually filter this shit?
Oh yeah.
I saw a fox today.
I take out all
house.
The swear words.
Did you really?
Well, at first you thought it was.
What was? How old was she?
Foxy.
Yeah, your wife in a swimsuit?
I saw some fox.
We first thought it was a coyote, but then we realized it was a fox, a mangy fox, totally mangy. Almost went on telecot, almost got hit, and people like stopping, looking.
Really?
And it comes right back up the street and goes right across.
Wow, awesome.
It was crazy.
I've seen coyotes before.
I've seen coyotes too.
I've never seen a fox.
And I'm not sure this was a fox. It was reddish.
Yeah, we had a...
And it would have been big for a fox.
I think it's a red fox.
Yeah, we had a red fox in Cortland that used to live in our bush. It was like a little...
I guess. You ever shower? Try some of that medicated powder.
All of my shit today. Living in my bush. Simmer down, guy. Simmer down.
I had to pull a simmer down to Terry at my house watching the Winter Classic.
What did I do?
Stadium series?
I gave you a simmer down for something. You were getting a little rowdy.
Because you're kicking your ass and golden tea.
In your own game.
Do you know who Arnie States is?
Arnie States? No.
I don't know if it's too fat to stand up. He must be a comedian, but we got the Bacon and Hockey podcast, but it's his picture on here. I don't know what that is.
What?
So speaking of Red Fox, one of my favorite jokes ever was from, you guys remember Red Fox?
Sure.
Oh, yeah.
That's right, dummy.
He did great stand-up, and one of his jokes was, and I'm not very good at telling jokes, but...
In a way, way
go ahead, come on.
Ladies and gentlemen,
that woman's got a terrible case of the Zachleys. Her breath smells exactly like her ass. Yeah. It's classic.
That's right.
The Zachleys. You got the Zachleys.
I was thinking of Fred Sanford when you were going to say, I thought you were going to say, you know, Emily, here I come.
It's Elizabeth. Elizabeth. Good old Red Fox. He was like the dirtiest guy in the world. And Aunt Esther was dirty, too. I forgot what her name is for real. But she was like another.
That was a great show.
Yeah. Oh, it was awesome.
Which one, the Red Fox show?
No, Sanford. You know, Aunt Esther was like, I forgot. She used to do comedy records with him and stuff. And that's Quincy Jones song there. Get that on there, Kenny. I know you got your.
I can do that. What do you want there?
Get the street. It's the Street Beater by Quincy Jones.
Street Beater.
Jesus, Jack Zimmer. He knows exactly.
That's a great song.
Hey, Dan. Name the theme song?
Dan, can you give me
by who? Quincy Jones?
Quincy Jones, the Street Beater.
Yeah, I got that.
It's actually like the whole song is great.
Let's see if it cues up here.
Let's see if you can get it there.
It's
ladies
coming.
And gentlemen, it's... Yes, ladies and gentlemen.
You should see the picture he has on his computer. Yeehaw!
Lamont, you dummy!
Isn't that kind of like the fish intro too?
Yeah. Come on, come here, dummy. Give me one of these. Cross your lips. That's the Street Beater, ladies and gentlemen. That's Quincy Jones, man. That's good. That's good stuff.
I mean, kudos to you for knowing. It's called Street Beater.
Jack knows a lot of useless shit.
I
now what? Has anybody fucking quieted their goddamn cell phones?
I have.
This is a guy. Oh, you know what? The on-air light's not on. That's why.
That's right. Like, see,
this is on. It actually throws a little something extra into the show.
That's right. Anything can happen tonight here at Podcast Central.
The added noise of the cell phones.
That's right. Well, we're live, ladies and gentlemen. We're live.
We just want to show everybody that this is a real show.
And
we're real people.
Yeah, we're five morons in a garage.
We get real phone calls from real people.
I'll tell you what, we're big in China, too.
Oh, are you kidding? Chinese freaking love this kind of stuff. They go
China,
for this.
Are they still our second biggest country?
Canada's second. Actually, other regions, which means they don't know where they're coming from,
yes.
Is number two. Canada's three and China is four.
That's right. They're listening in the Spratly Islands. You know those islands that the Chinese are they're building up to put air bases on? And
it drops off significantly down to France, Germany, UK, Netherlands, Spain, Sweden, India, Finland, Ireland, Australia,
India.
Philippines, and Japan.
India? What?
Oh, yeah. Slumdog.
Yeah, well, you know why? Because we're gonna be training them to take our jobs soon.
We're going to outsource the show to India.
Yes. Hello, I am Action Johnson.
No, Ken's been handing out his card up at the 7-Eleven.
Yeah. Why do you gotta make it racial?
I'm not. I'm just saying.
Well, what's the point about the 7-Eleven?
Hey, did you make business cards for Dan?
I can make some business cards. I'll get him an email address tomorrow.
No, I don't think that's
necessary. Yeah.
It's definitely.
You guys are like pulling me right in, aren't you?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Can you write us a check for five bills?
Do you
500? It's a $500 buy-in.
Yeah, you can write him a check. Yes.
Sad part about it is it wouldn't pay us off.
Third party out of state bad check.
Oh, Terry paid me this week.
You don't give us numbers.
I gave you numbers 2 weeks ago.
What was it?
We'll talk about it.
Let's worry about that some other time, ladies and gentlemen. That's right.
Paid who what?
Pay to do this.
Pay to the order of.
This isn't free, my friend.
Well, we only have to pay once we reconcile all the income. We have to come up with.
Let's face it. The booze costs more than it costs to run a show.
So does your mic.
Yes.
Almost.
Hey.
I mean the cable and the stand. The mic, no.
Yeah, that's a whole.
It's got
$20 setup.
That's vomit protection right there.
That's $5 bills.
Yeah. Feel free to vomit.
Yeah. Feel free.
If you have to vomit, you can do it on Dan's mic.
Right on the mic.
It's protected.
Right on the mic.
Our I don't think our mics are vomit protected.
I don't think so.
Next time Dave comes in, we need to put. You know how they have the drum, the plexiglass thing. We need to put him in the corner with the plexiglass around him.
You know, like when they have live shows and they put the drummer behind the plexiglass.
Yeah, exactly. Dave or Jeremy.
Yes.
Of course, Jeremy didn't puke, but he was right there.
And he may have puked later.
He didn't puke here.
He didn't puke at TBK either, but...
But he
dropped that whole fucking burrito went on the ground.
Yes.
On his lap.
He went lap and ground and hit ground. After he's done, he just continues eating. I'm like, you're just eating a tortilla, dude.
All the
filling is on the ground.
The tortilla had to be
two foot wide,
and he's trying to pull it up like a blanket.
All right, Kenny, I'm closing the door.
Now it's cold.
Close the door. It's getting a little chilly. Hey, I got a hockey... We got to get some hockey out of the way here. Who's the number two team in the league this year that wins when they score first?
The number two team wins when they score first. I'm going to go ahead and say it's the Washington Capitals, Kenny.
Terrence?
Dallas.
Wild.
Dan?
Fuck if I know.
The Wild.
You're closest. Because neither do these guys.
How about Florida?
Florida Panthers.
Boo, you suck.
Ladies and gentlemen. They have won 28 times when they scored first.
They're not a bad team.
Mm-mm. And you know who's six games better than them is your very own Chicago Blackhawks sitting at the top.
They're fucking
the
roll right now.
They didn't win that one. That's right.
I mean, I'm participating in a podcast regarding hockey when I really know nothing about hockey.
Well, we were talking about the street beater 5 minutes ago, so it could change any minute, Dan. Yeah. Don't let that fool you or
much
sway.
More of a street beater kind of a guy.
Have you ever seen a webpage or a website?
I have, yeah.
Your dog knows more than hockey than we do.
Yes.
Interesting, the Blackhawks only lost now up today, if I updated, it's five times when they score first. They've only lost five
Hawks
times.
Are from Chicago, right?
Correct.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Are you glad I left it over here?
Uh-oh.
We got a little problem, ladies and gentlemen. The podcast heating system has failed. Sexy Terry is changing the tank even as we speak.
Actually, you know what, Jack? I didn't give you proper credit there.
Oh, okay. For what?
Because the Capitals are tied with the Panthers with 28.
Whoa, see? Yeah. There you go.
That was why I spoke.
That's going to be an exciting playoff right there. The East, the Southeast of it. The Southeast used to be the shittiest division. Now it's pretty good.
Let's see.
You never know. Hockey is a capricious. You never know what year. Every year it could change.
Special teams. You want to hear some special
hell
teams?
Hell yeah, I do. Who's the power play, the top of the power play charts there, Kenny?
Boy.
Is it the Anaheim Ducks?
Special teams. What's FO?
What's
the FOW percent?
What's FOW percent stand for?
Yeah.
Do you know?
Oh, face-off win percentage. Uh-oh. Sorry. Who's the number one team in face-off win percentage?
I'm going to have to say it's the Florida Panthers.
It is Southeast, but it's not Florida.
It's going to be
Tampa Bay.
Carolina Hurricanes.
No what? Way. Wow.
53.9%.
Who's their guy?
Where do they
Stahl
play?
Or?
Yeah, Eric Stahl, probably. Where do they play?
Mm, Charlotte?
It's in Charlotte, I believe. Yeah. Charlotte, yeah. Or is it Raleigh? Or are they playing Raleigh?
And Vermont is part of making Arizona number two.
Yeah.
Arizona's another good team that
closely behind him. 53.6. Isn't that weird?
We have heat.
The Minnesota Wild is number 3.
Best part, Terry, is that we open all the doors and the fucking heat goes out.
Well, how about the Minnesota Wild? Their coach got fired, and now they're on a little bit of a maybe they need
is
a little.
Is that Tortorella's in now?
No, Tortorella's on. He's Columbus.
Oh, who's the coach then?
It's some guy that they just. He's like their assistant coach. Who I don't even know what his name is.
I always liked what's his face.
Mike Yeo. I like him too.
Where's he going? He's going to end somewhere.
So he'll go somewhere. He'll be somebody's assistant coach for a while. He'll be back. He'll be back, ladies and gentlemen. Don't you worry about old Mike Yeo.
About the number one team in power play percentage.
Number one power play team is the Anaheim Ducks.
It is Washington Capitals. Oh, my Blackhawks
God.
Are number two.
Oh, my God.
How do you
God.
Figure that percentage?
It's whether you score on the power play or not.
That's it?
Penalty kill.
It's like the penalty kill.
Probably the Blackhawks.
Dan, you get too much wrapped in it.
So the penalty kill is the opposite side.
Ooh,
of the power
penalty
it's like kills. It's like it's a good percentage is 80-20. You want to kill 80% and score 20%. So.
And the Blackhawks are sitting right at 80 at number 17.
Mm-hmm.
New York Islanders 87.2% PK.
Is that Letty?
That's Letty.
Anaheim Ducks number 2.
Oh, my God.
You okay, Mike? Yeah.
He's got some kind of tropical disease, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, you didn't get that fucking
Zika
bit
virus.
By mosquito,
you get this. He's got, what's
Zika
that?
Zika virus.
The Zika virus. Zika virus.
I got all.
He might be pregnant.
Yeah.
I was listening to Howard Stern. He's like, man, I wish this would have happened back then because we'd have more Beetlejuices. He goes, I'm going to be retired by the time these kids get the age. They can fuck with them.
Beetlejuice. Is he still on the show?
Oh, yeah. He was on there this week. Oh, my God. He was shot out of a cannon. They played a game on there called The Answer is 5. Answer is 5. Answer is 5. And then you go, if I have 5 jelly beans and I give you 5 jelly beans, how many do you have? 0. None. What's 2 plus 3? 7. Count, you know, the answer is 5. They keep on saying the answer is 5. And, and every single time, something else. You had to listen. It was pretty good, though.
Well, if anybody who doesn't know who Beetlejuice is, he looks like he's had the Zika virus for his whole life.
The shrunken head.
Yeah.
How about one more trivia question?
Sure, Kenny, let's go. Shootout games won. There hasn't been as many shootout games. I think the 3-on-3 has been a success, so I'm going to say it's...
That could be
I'll tell you, the top team
Pittsburgh
has
Penguins.
Six.
Pittsburgh
six.
Penguins.
Pittsburgh is.
You think who
below 21?
How about Dallas?
Oh my God,
Dallas is 19.
Hawks
at 2. At only 2.
Hawks haven't been in that many.
No.
Chicago Blackhawks are not even in
the
top
21. Well, they haven't had as many shootout games as there have been. The 3-on-3 has been a success, I think, as far as reducing the amount of shootout games. Yeah.
What about the Calgary Flames?
Calgary Flames, Kenny.
Calgary Flames are 18 with 2. A bunch of these.
All right, give
two.
Us a division they're in.
I will tell you that it's one is the East and one is I think the West. They're tied. It's 6.
6. Okay.
Well, we're back where we started.
Yeah, so that could be anybody.
How about a division.
One is Florida.
Florida.
Tampa Bay.
Panthers. And number 2, who's tied with Florida, is the Ottawa Senators.
Wow.
With 6.
They're both East.
And the Canadians are 5, and Toronto's 5. I guessed that Ottawa being in the West.
No.
Sorry.
Sorry. Let's play Know Your Provinces, Kenny.
let's do this. So right. 6 is leading, and we're 3/4 of the way.
That's really not that many shootout games.
No, let's see what they were last year.
But that's what they wanted, you know? Mm-hmm. I mean, I kind of like the shootouts every once in a while. Just
every once in a while.
Interesting.
But I like the 3. I like the 3-on-3.
Interesting. Last year, how many was the top? Shootout wins last year. Year that they're never going to.
It's
not getting there.
It's got to be at least probably
like 13
to 15.
Yeah,
10.
Wow,
that's it.
10. Colorado Avalanche. The Blackhawks were number 2 at 9. Tied with the Blue Jackets. Tied with the Blues.
Well, how about that?
Like that, Dan?
Were you putting your cigar out on there? Look at that. He's a proud papa.
It's like, I got a bike.
He adjusted it himself, ladies and gentlemen. Look, he's a professional broadcaster
that
now.
Shit-eating grin on there.
So have any of you guys ever driven from here to Florida?
Oh, yes. Yes. Oh, yeah. Many times.
Non-stop, as a matter of fact.
All right. So we're making stops. We're leaving room for stops. We're spring break.
Mm-hmm. Where are you going?
Oh, we're going
Florida.
To...
Asshole.
Didn't he just say that, Terry? Come on.
Well, I know that, but we're at in Florida.
We're going to Anna Maria Island.
Oh,
which
sure.
Which is just south of Tampa.
Okay.
Oh, right. Terrific.
Right. Oh,
and we're just trying to plan the trip to make it fun. And
good restaurants in Chattanooga, Dan.
Fun.
Chattanooga. But, I mean, where to stop? You know,
stop
we
at Asheville.
I mean,
every Waffle House.
Do you see the Mammoth Cave? Do you see the Chattanooga, the Lookout Mountain?
No.
What's the...
No.
Avoid
no,
Lookout Mountain, but there's excellent restaurants in Chattanooga proper now.
I'm talking about the kids.
Go to Huntsville to that.
I mean,
aerospace,
all right. If you like history shit, there's some cool... Like, there's a Stones River just outside of Nashville. It's kind of a cool park to go see.
No, that's
go
too
to Knoxville
close, though.
And go
that's
to
right
the
off the highway.
Yeah, yeah, you still want to go farther than Nashville.
You could go to Dollywood.
Yeah, you talking about staying for the night? Or?
Well, yeah. Here's what we're doing is we want to make almost like a three-day trip out of it. On the way down.
Sure.
It'll be a two-day trip on the way back.
If you take 75 and 65 all the way down.
How long are you gone for spring break? That's 5 days. That's your spring break. You're getting there and turn around coming back?
No. I mean, you get the weekend involved, too. So. But we're thinking about driving to Louisville, mm-hmm. which is like
five hours.
Yeah.
Staying there and seeing whatever's there. And then driving the next day. To there's a town, I can't remember what it's called. It's right on the border of Florida and Georgia. It's like a little redneck town.
Isn't that a name of a band? Florida Georgia Line?
Florida Georgia Line.
What about
Line.
like Gatlinburg or something?
Gatlinburg.
Yeah, in the Smokies, right?
Yeah. That's gorgeous there.
Absolutely.
We've thought about that, too.
And that's about 9.5 hours.
That's a good place to get fireworks right on the Georgia-Tennessee border. Terry should know about that.
I'm taking a break this year.
You know, I mean,
no 4th of July party.
There's lots of
Thank
stuff
you,
to go
Park
see.
Ridge Police, for that.
Yeah, there's good stuff to see. There's
You're
good stuff
pussy.
To see.
We're just leaving some time on the way down to see some stuff, right? And on the way back, we're going
straight, pretty much
right.
through. Yeah, well, you can kind of do that trip.
I
one
still
bit.
Say do the Smoky Mountains. Spend a day and a half in the Smokies.
But where? In Chattanooga?
Well, no, I would like Gatlinburg.
But Gatlinburg's a little off the beaten path if you're going down to
Yeah,
Tampa,
but you can
though.
Go through like the Blue Ridge Parkway.
Yeah, that's
go all
true.
The way through there.
Yeah.
It's going to take a while to go through there, but it's just gorgeous
it's a beautiful
to drive
part
through
of,
there.
It's well, a beautiful country.
It's kind of in the country. Yeah, it is in the country, isn't it?
Yeah.
Stop at a farm.
All right, come on. I'll shut the fuck up.
No,
really.
Kenny
seriously.
Has an attitude tonight.
Yeah, Kenny's got a little,
fucking burr up his ass.
He's got an edge.
You can make Gatlinburg in a day, no problem.
Take the microphone away from this guy.
I'm just trying to switch subjects after 20 minutes.
Or Asheville. even
Asheville. Asheville's supposed
beautiful.
To be cool, yeah.
Asheville.
North Carolina.
Get a piece.
North Carolina.
Nashville.
North Carolina's
Asheville.
I'm kidding. You've seen Road Trip.
Terry took
far,
his
right?
mom there, so he's all about North Carolina now.
Charleston's a little mom. Off the beaten path of that trip, but Charleston's pretty great.
Love
no,
Charleston.
It's got to be on the way, and Asheville's not on the way.
Well, there's Nashville.
Yeah.
The big cities
well,
you're
going
to hit are Louisville.
I mean, if you're driving Atlanta. All the way to Florida, you're basically going through Asheville.
No, you're not. It takes 65. You go through Nashville.
You go through Nashville,
yeah.
and you go through Chattanooga.
You don't go through the west side over there, but stop in Atlanta. You got the Coke Museum. You got CNN.
Yeah. There you go.
You got the zoo, which the zoo is kind of interesting there.
Yeah.
It's not bad.
Absolutely.
But Coke is kind of interesting.
Yeah, the Coke Museum's cool. I mean, I think when I was a kid, we used to go all the time with my grandparents, and Chattanooga was a piece of crap. And now it's like really kind of a neat town to go see.
Yeah, like they got the
You know what there's? You know what they got in? You know what they got in Chattanooga is an awesome aquarium. You take the kids to see that.
I heard about that. Yeah.
Aquarium stuff.
No, I don't think we want to like spend.
Yeah, if you're taking little
look as a fish.
Angry look. Mike.
Fucking hate aquarium.
No, I think.
Did Mike stop drinking again?
I think.
This sucks. This sucks.
I mean, I'm partial to Chattanooga because I think it's a cool place. It's in the mountains. It's a cool city. There's good eats there. There's. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, Chattanooga. And you know, I like the Civil War shit, but there's good stuff to do in Nashville nowadays, or in Chattanooga nowadays.
If you stay east, Huntsville's cool. They have that aerospace museum there. Mm-hmm. Really fucking cool.
I've been there.
Huntsville, yeah.
I used to live not far from Huntsville.
Oh, yeah.
So there you go. So there's stuff to do. Some of it's a little off, but if you're going straight down 65 and 75, then yeah, there's a limit to what you can see. But there's stuff. Thank you, Kitty.
See, dead serious.
Ken's like, this sucks.
He's keeping this fucking thing rolling.
When I listen to this Who's 8 times while I produce it, this is going to be a blast.
Jesus.
So there's 8 listens right there. Yeah. Thanks, Kenny.
It is. That's maybe. Yeah. Hey. You know, sometimes I fake my IP address to pretend I'm in China.
Yes. They have the moon pie stuff is in Chattanooga. There's
I thought that was a Maine thing.
No, moon pie is Chattanooga.
Really?
But see, here's the
it's
thing.
It's big in Maine, I know.
It's also Mountain Dew country. It's from Mountain
so
Dew,
Ken Maine. listens to this podcast, what, 6-7 times you said?
A lot.
I go home, you know, Men in Black thing. I fucking vape my fucking self. So I totally forget this fucking thing because I don't ever want to hear it again.
I figure I live it. I don't have to listen to it again.
I got a question for you.
But Atlanta's good. Yes,
go
Kenny.
Just interject a little hockey back in
here.
Sure, let's back on track.
Sure, okay.
See how I like how I do that?
Sure, Kenny, okay.
The original six.
Yes.
Are Montreal, Boston, Detroit, New York, Toronto, and Chicago, correct?
Yep. Yes.
Yes.
How many games have those six played over the next winningest team in NHL history?
What?
The next winningest team is Philadelphia Flyers with 1,881 wins and 3,778 games.
Yeah.
How many more wins does the bottom of the original six?
It'll be Detroit.
It is actually Detroit. Why is that, Jack?
Because then they win, like, how many Stanley Cups they win during the late 90s, early 2000s?
I actually got to redo my math.
What do they have, 13?
I think a
13
better
cups?
Question would be, besides the original six, who has the most wins outside the original
I
six?
I can give you that would one, that too. But I thought it was interesting in number of games, because I'm looking at all time, the number of games played. It's actually sorted by wins.
Mm-hmm.
And the number seven team in games or in wins is 2,100 games behind the original six.
Hey, Dan.
Well, but the original six was like the only game in town up until the 60s.
But I mean, 2,000 games worth?
Well, I mean, they played for 30 years before.
That many.
Yeah.
Hey,
yeah.
I mean, hey, Dan, can you unplug Ken's computer?
Yeah. Well, okay. All right. Well, they talked about this. They talked about the expansion.
I got to get this computer on its own circuit.
Oh, we lost power here. Click. What the hell is going on?
They talked about the expansion in like 1967, 66. And that was the expansion after the original six. And that's where you got like your Blues and Kings and Flyers and Penguins and Buffalo and... What's the other one? And North Stars.
And okay.
There's another one.
California Golden Seals.
And the California Golden Seals, ladies and gentlemen.
Seriously.
So, hey, has anyone made the trip from Chicago up to, like, Montreal?
I've been to Montreal.
Any ideas, like, where to stop and stuff?
What, the Montreal?
No, Dan's a spot. He's a
spot. Hey, listen,
Kenny's like, "What are you doing, Dan?"
Actually, in all honesty,
kids, you know,
Montreal is a badass city to go see. There's like a fort. There's like,
they got a yurt.
I honeymoon. Yeah, they have a yurt. I honeymoon there. Montreal's a terrific place. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, are they still like trapping fur and stuff?
They are. I think, like, if you go like an hour and a half out of town, north, yes, they are. South, it's.
Wee wee, baby.
And you can get all the ice cream you can eat there. Yeah.
Well, you know that's where the ice cream capital of the world is, right?
Montreal.
Yeah.
I did not know that.
Yeah, that's where the museum is.
The ice cream museum.
Yeah.
Jesus.
I didn't even know there was an ice cream museum.
Oh yeah.
Are you gonna prove them wrong?
So outside the original six, what's the most winningest team in hockey?
Philadelphia Flyers.
Very good, Terry.
I believe you said that about 3 minutes ago.
No, I didn't. Did
yes,
I?
Yes, you did. That's why.
All right, who's number eight?
That's why I framed.
Who's number eight? St. Louis Blues.
Very good, Terrence. Wow. They're 1,100 behind Philadelphia.
Terrence is.
Oh, he knows his.
Hey, the Blues.
I know my second six.
All right, hang on a second.
That's right. The second six.
All right, who is in all of the NHL, who is the – oh, this is great. Who's the least winningest NHL professional team in hockey?
Ever?
That's still going?
Ever.
Current?
Ever.
Atlanta Flames.
How about the Kansas City Scouts?
Yeah, well, they were only a team for like a year, right?
They're 27-110.
How about the Chiefs?
Charlestown
Chiefs.
You got what was the hockey team in Detroit before the Red Wings?
No, I don't know.
The Falcons.
I did not know that.
The Hamilton Tigers, Cleveland Barons. And of the current, who's the losingest of the current NHL teams?
All right. Of the current?
Arizona.
Current as of when?
Columbus Blue Jackets.
No.
Arizona.
You should listen to somebody who might look at my screen.
Is an NHL team?
What?
Like, seriously?
Like, what? Say that. Of the you just looked at
the current.
Yeah.
Arizona, no.
I would.
How
about Florida Panthers?
Arizona.
How would I? Do you see how small that is?
The Detroit,
not Ken's unit, Ken's screen.
You know who's above Arizona? The Detroit.
Everybody. Didn't you say they're last?
No. Kansas City Scouts, the Falcons, the Tigers, the Barons, the Detroit Cougars. Detroit had three teams?
I didn't know that.
Oakland Seals, there they are, 68-118.
They didn't last very long.
And the Pittsburgh Pirates, interesting, 67-122.
They are playing hockey now.
Toronto St. Patrick's. Who is the number two? Oh, no, Colorado Rockies. They're not a real team. California Seals, New York Americans, Ottawa Senators, Atlanta Flames, Montreal Maroons.
I don't know what you guys are talking about.
Yeah, but we still talk about
hockey? A lot of those teams turn into
other stuff.
Other teams.
Yeah, like the Vancouver Millionaires and stuff like that. They were an NHL team briefly, in the 20s.
Minnesota Lakers?
Minnesota Lakers.
I don't see
the greatest basketball team to ever play hockey.
George Mikan, man.
Yeah.
George Mikan. I was just showing off my hockey knowledge.
They're very nice, Kenny.
Very nice. Very nice.
I wish you guys could see the font on this thing.
Is it Comic Sans?
It's got to be like 0.3.
Kenny's got good eyes. I don't know if I could read that.
Except when he's texting.
Where he has like, 60 point type on his.
This should be the size of the keyboard on his phone.
Boop, boop. That's Kenny.
Seriously.
Kenny just gave you a withering
come on,
look.
Kenny
uses an iPad as a phone.
I love those guys that do it. And it freaks me out because I'm sitting there and we're standing in the office. I'll be talking and one guy will be like, pull out his like iPhone 9 or whatever the fuck they got.
Yeah.
Samsung. Oh,
it looks like
they're clipped on the belt. It is. It's a fucking iPad.
It's the size of those, like, the Motorola phones from World War II. Yeah. The size of a shoebox.
I've always said I'll never have a cell phone bigger than my unit.
Well, then your cell phone must be very, hello? Very.
Hello?
Yes.
Hello.
What's that?
Motorola Razr.
That's right, the Razr.
The Star Tech.
Yeah.
No, the movie. Zoolander?
Yes.
He's like that.
Yeah. Tiniest phone.
That was a funny movie, I must
hilarious.
Say.
Hilarious.
There's a new Zoolander. I love
Zoolander
that movie.
2?
Yeah.
You know, I don't think I ever saw it. But
I never saw
Owen Wilson.
You never saw Zoolander?
I never saw the first one.
It's highly recommended.
Yeah, you gotta see it.
It's the best movie about male modeling ever made.
It's just so wrong, everything about it.
What was
it?
Oh,
you're so right.
It was Fabergé.
Yeah.
Fabergé. What was that? The Eddie Murphy one with the girl or Strange.
Boomerang.
Is
boomerang,
that what it is?
Yeah.
Oh, she's got hammer-toe.
That's when the dad sits at the dinner table, and he's like, "Oh, you got coordinate. He's got mushroom belt inside of his jacket's mushrooms.
Yeah,
you got coordinate."
Scotty O'Hottie beer, bacon, chipotle, hot sauce. I found a recipe that I was going to make tonight for you guys. Yeah. Uses Big Fats hot sauce.
But wait, you had, but you had class tonight.
How'd
your class go, Kenny?
Yeah, what was the class stuff?
It was none of us did. It was personal growth class at the Discovery Center.
I thought
Big
it was
Fats
a
hot
class.
Sauce.
You know what
gentlemen?
We missed so far? No one has said taint.
Hasn't been. Has it?
That's good. That's a good thing.
Well, it's,
no, it's got to be mentioned.
That's
it's usually within the first 10 minutes of the show.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
We have a checklist.
Yeah.
It's like, yes.
Taint, penis.
Yes. Nobody's
taint
mentioned.
Anal bleaching.
Yeah, jizz.
Anal bleaching.
Yeah, jizz has not been mentioned yet, so. We still have a few on our checklist to go through there.
Anal bleaching.
There it is. Is your taint?
There you go. Mark it off.
Thanks,
it
Dad.
Off. Yeah.
Have you ever beaded your taint?
I don't know about you. I've never seen my taint.
Well, you don't have a mirror then.
Yeah. Well, if I did, I do, but I'm not looking.
Spot over
taint.
It. You know, no, spot seriously. Over and look.
Why
seriously.
The fuck would I look?
Taint the...
That was.
See, look what happens when we don't talk about hockey.
Yeah. That was season three.
That was, that's one of those things that. Yeah.
Oh no! Those were fucked up. Yeah, those
these
were not,
all
I don't know,
no, that
up.
Was
they're all fucked.
No,
up. But I mean
Terry wasn't even here. I think we just
destroyed.
Had the keys and we came out here.
That wasn't
you,
that
me,
day, was it?
You, no, me, my brother. Yeah, taintal bleeding was.
No, I was here. That was an actual podcast.
That was a podcast.
That was a podcast.
Really?
Yeah.
Thanks for listening, Ken.
Yeah, you're the archive guy.
Yes.
Kenny's got all the sound drops.
He's so
ready
proud.
To go.
Hey! Yeah.
Oh, now he's mad.
Oh,
no,
oh,
he's mad.
Did I upset you? No.
Feelings are hurt.
Feelings. Hey, that's what we got to do next.
We should
talk about our
feelings.
All right, you're going to the game Sunday?
I'll do it. I'm going to the game
Dick
on Sunday.
Dick fingers over all here. Right.
Yeah.
I think I'm pulling out the
griddle. No, don't do anything.
Pulling out the griddle.
Yeah,
on,
don't pull it out.
Pulling out the griddle on Sunday, whoever wants
it,
to come by.
It's supposed to be nice?
Do you know what I'm... It's
supposed to be 55.
Seriously.
Yeah.
Short man, weather for
I got. I think I like a griddle fried hamburger better than a grilled
ooh,
hamburger.
Yeah.
You know what?
Oh, totally.
You know why? I think we overdid it. I think we overdid it with you know, all we had was fried as kids growing up, so all of a sudden the barbecue was like, wow, this is like a different burger.
It's
now,
great.
Now that all you eat, I prefer fried burgers.
No, fried burgers.
Five Guys.
It tastes better when it's fried.
I made them last
fat.
Night. I mean, we couldn't think of what, you know, we got to feed the kids something, and I had some ground beef. I have a big old cast iron. I made them like steak and shake style. You pick like a ball of meat and you smash it down so it's super thin, and then put it.
I
in.
Almost I
so
had
anyway,
burgers last night too.
Stop
I
on by Sunday.
Did it, but I fired
now,
up the grill.
I've got a funeral to go to on Sunday.
Ken's.
Stop and
roll. Ken's.
Yeah. Is it the podcast funeral?
Yes.
Aunt Roberta died.
I'm sorry to hear that. Your side or Jen's side?
My side, my father's side.
I'm sorry.
Should we do it, Aunt Roberta? You want some
Aunt
Jack there?
She was.
This one right there too. Or do you want this?
Yeah,
one?
There's
well,
some
yeah, it's...
She loved her VO. No one's but she was. She
that?
Was old school.
Seagram's VO, ladies
let's,
and gentlemen.
Let's have a drink
she
for Aunt Roberta.
I feel bad because I knew she.
Was I got a little of this still left. I'm good.
I never wanted to see her, and now she's
pass
dead.
It.
Do you know what?
Let's, she was a big fan of the show, too.
Oh, she was. She was huge, yeah.
She was our favorite listener.
Now we're down to two listeners. Way to go.
This goes to out to Aunt
Roberta.
She's going to score.
Anybody?
The big goal in the sky.
I still got a little of this rum left. I'm good.
Kenny?
I'm good.
For Aunt Roberta? Aunt Roberta?
Aunt Roberta.
Godspeed.
And, you know, she used to live across the street from Gary Fensick. So on Easter was a big day at because Gary Fensick would come over and she because
he's a big Easter guy?
Well, because
he was
Gary
the
Fensick
rabbit.
And he was a Chicago big time.
Oh, he's probably hitting on her at the time.
No, he was the president of Easter Seals.
You know, he was half her age, whatever. But
I don't think that mattered to him.
Here's to looking up your address.
You the Harvard guy.
Aunt Roberta.
And Gary Fensick.
Rest in peace.
Gary's dead too?
No.
To me, he is.
Isn't he in politics? Is he a. And Bob Thomas is a judge, right?
Bob, yeah. He
he's a judge.
Kickers are always judges. I don't know what that is, but I think Kevin Butler's a judge.
Kevin Butler, we're going to vote Kevin Butler for judge. Cook
County. Buford.
McMichael was a mayor.
Yeah.
McMichael was just out of control. Yeah, if they did, if they redid Blazing Saddles, he would be Alex Garris.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Well, that's how he got his name.
Mongo.
Punch a horse.
I saw McMichael in the parking lot at Soldier Field when we were tailgating, and he was really cool and took pictures, and he was probably hammered.
He was very cool. He was a crazy motherfucker. I remember watching Steve Dahl used to try to sell a video of his. For the New Year's Eve party. He'd have a New Year's Eve party in Sports Vision. I think, you know, you could pay per view to watch his New Year's Eve party. McMichael was in there and he fucked his house up big time a bunch of times. He was out of control.
Yeah, we can afford to fix it back up.
It's kind of like having Dave over.
Almost.
Oh, Jesus.
So, Jackie.
Yeah, Kenny.
What are we doing? Are we doing fantasy hockey?
Are we at that point already?
It seems like just a minute ago, but we're in a buck 20.
Yeesh. Really?
Buck all 23, right. Rolling.
Let's get to it.
That's not including this part when we started without recording.
Did he actually hit record for this?
Right now,
yeah.
This is the point where I take my headphones off.
We walk away.
So what time will we be home on Sunday?
I have no idea.
Okay. If we're still out, come on over.
I think the services start at 11.
You'll be home by 4.
I think I'm flying solo.
And they're in Darien.
That's not that
far. You're going to use a sock, or are you just going to let it spray all over the shower?
Both. Kids have V-show.
Now, who's got V-show? Is it just Ella?
Ella. But no, Sophia's helping Kristen. She's the director. And then I have to go down to Sox Academy at 3 for practice.
Is Kristen on
Sunday?
But I'll be there in the morning. What's that?
V show's a big thing.
Yeah.
Oh, I know that. You know,
it is stupid, though.
Yeah, but no, it's not stupid. It's actually kind of good.
You ought to move to Washington School District or Field School District.
Oh, fuck that. Because the parents do
the V show.
They do.
You know what? I agree with Dan.
We're talking about a variety show that K through 5th grade.
But it's cute when the kids do it. When the parents do it,
it's gay.
It's a little weird.
Right.
Well,
exactly.
At Roosevelt, they don't. The parents don't do it.
No, but the parents get just as overly out of control.
The parents write it and they produce it and stuff like that. And it's funny, you know. They make fun of Noreen at Walgreens.
Oh, that was hysterical.
I was in the line at Walgreens and Noreen was there and there was this young guy.
She's the Irish girl, old lady.
Yeah.
And
would you like to buy some chocolates?
Would you like some
chocolates? How about some chocolates?
Hello, honey. Would you like some of these peanut butter cups?
The chocolates are for sale. How would you like some chocolates?
There's 2-for-1 today.
Yeah.
she's a sweetheart.
She is.
Ladies and gentlemen, our
poster person for
we need to get her on the podcast.
For all of our listeners.
Oh, yeah. She would do it too. She would totally do it.
I'm gonna go, honey. I'll bring some chocolates to the show. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, for all of our listeners and our listeners in Sweden, Noreen is the elderly Irish lady that works at our local Walgreens, and she's sort of like a local celeb.
We've got Irish listeners. You don't have to reach out to Sweden.
Well, I'm just saying for people that don't know who Noreen is, other than us, and
or people in Park Ridge.
Yeah.
Everybody in Park Ridge knows.
Yes, she's a lovely lady. Works at the yes. She's got to be in her 70s.
We should get Chuck on the show.
Yes, Chuck's another guy who works at the local Walgreens. Yeah,
Noreen has to be on the show. That would be huge.
I'll go get a soundbite from her.
It's Chuck the guy that uses that stuff to
you walk in and Chuck just, hey, how you doing? Yeah. Hey. It's like,
hey, guys, what's up?
I'll get a soundbite.
Yeah,
I actually saw Noreen last night.
Her commit to come here and actually sit.
If I was her, I'd be scared to fucking
die. I'll give her a gift card for the restaurant or whatever, as a little incentive. And
all right.
She would, I mean, that would be hysterical.
Do you think she'll wear something sexy?
I hope so. Like a little black tassel or something.
Oh, yeah. Something.
And tassels.
Yeah.
You want her to come on, Terry? Keep it up.
She looks like...
Hey, if she's here, it'll be up.
She's not a listener.
Oh, no. Oh,
yes.
No.
She's got to be
oh,
78
no.
years old.
And the thing is, I mean, she's cool about this stuff.
Oh,
she
she's a delight.
Her,
she's
know.
Great.
Yeah.
You know what she puts up with in there?
She's a local treasure, ladies and gentlemen. Local treasure.
Yes, she is.
Now, put in your number. You know, your...
Yeah.
Your digits.
Oh, sorry. You don't qualify for...
Yeah. Oh, sorry, honey. Yes. Would you like
I walked in there one time because it's
Would you like some Charleston shoes? They're on sale.
I said, can I have some of the King condoms there? Oh, sure, honey.
King condoms.
The King.
The Magnums.
Yeah. Would you like me to put them on for you?
Yeah. And, then, and all she does, I mean, she's on the money. She just.
I'm wondering if a bag of ice and it cost me over $3. I'm going, you're charging me over $3 for 5 pounds of ice.
Oh, honey. Oh, it's...
Well,
it's,
put in your number and it, maybe it's on sale.
It's the entertainment value.
And do you want some M&M?
Would you like some chocolates?
Yes. Yes. Two
three.
For one today,
I
honey.
I see three.
The Hershey's are for sale this week.
Would you like some gum?
Oh, she's
something. She's good material. I mean...
Oh, man.
Really.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's 20 fucking people in line.
She moves that
she
line.
No,
good.
She doesn't.
Yeah, she does.
No, she talked to her.
Yeah.
Yeah, she. I see her hands are moving.
She's
yeah.
doing something. It just isn't.
Yeah,
she isn't doing it very fast. That's
she's wonderful.
She is.
But
absolutely.
We all love her. I mean,
we
as
do.
A community, we love her.
We do. She's serious. She's a local treasure.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah she is.
Come on out to Park Ridge, ladies and gentlemen. Come out to the Walgreens on Devon Avenue and Talcott.
And,
7224.
You won't be able to park because they screwed the parking lot all up. But
they're working on it.
They're going to level the building, though, right?
Yeah, and that's going to be a parking lot there, yeah, I think.
Has to be because right now it sucks. It's,
and
then the
no,
thing is, how
that,
many...
That'll be the new Walgreens.
No, it's,
no,
it's
they're
gonna
building
be
new
Dick
Walgreens.
Goods.
What's that?
Dick's Sporting Goods.
Shut up. You know what sucks, though? How many spots does Atletico get in that parking lot?
They get like
lot?
15
it's
of
like,
them.
There's 15 fucking spots.
No, I think it's like four.
No.
It's like
no,
four.
No, no, no,
no.
It's
more
they,
like
at least, they at least have eight.
They have half the parking lot is Atletico.
Seriously.
It's yeah. local Park Ridge
talk,
ladies and gentlemen.
How many people are fucking hurt?
That's they're waiting to tear down the old Walgreens.
It's so a local crisis, ladies and gentlemen. They took down the yes. The
and you know what? And I parked there, and my oldest son, who's like the rule follower, he's like, "Dad, you're parking." In
the oh, I always park there.
And I do too, and I get out and limp.
Let them ticket me. I'm gonna be in there for like I'm getting a gas station in Walgreens, right?
Yes, you can blame them for taking away most of the parking spots and. Putting like planters in instead.
Speaking of tickets and that, I heard on the news.
Ladies
the other
and gentlemen,
day,
please doff your hats. For
don't park in the hand. That's just like parking in a fucking handicap.
It's not handicap.
No. In Atletico,
no.
Those
fuckers are there for rehab.
But no. Not 15. They have.
They don't need. They don't need
three
eight,
people
trust,
that are working.
They have at least eight spots.
Trust me,
yes.
Dan. If you want to stay out of
the
fucking
lease.
If you want to stay out of the fucking hospital again, walk a little bit more.
Jesus. Speaking of tickets, I heard this the other day that you know the sticker tickets. You know, they've looked at where the most tickets are written. And it's all Schaumburg police in Woodfield parking lot.
Oh,
they
sure.
Go,
they go
through Woodfield parking lot, look at their ticket, and then write tickets just left and right.
I work across the street from that, and they're fucking brutal. They used to pull us over every – I mean, they sit there, and because it's perimeter drive, so it's like it circles at speed limits 25. Well, fucking everybody's doing 35 through
I'm
there,
going 90 to that fucking
over.
Thing.
Yeah.
You I know what? I walk across that street.
I'm looking for you.
This cigar is lovely.
Isn't that good?
I mean, just burns nice.
Extra thanks for rookie Mike.
Thank you, Mikey.
Bringing him all the way back from the exotic Caribbean.
Right up your anus.
That's really good.
I went cheap on the booze, but I went heavy
you
on
did
the...
You didn't.
Well,
you stop it. Simmer down.
Jesus Christ. Okay. What the fuck?
Kenny's good and cranky tonight, ladies and
gentlemen. And Dan's done. He's only allowed an hour and a half, and he's like, fuck this.
Dan's like, I gotta go. All
right, let's do this thing here.
You gonna do that, or are we just gonna...
No, hold on. We gotta do the...
Oh,
come on. We gotta
Kenny,
do...
man.
It's ladies a tradition.
Kill Whitey's
hey,
way
Jack,
down
there.
Oh, fuck,
I'm at the bottom, so I'm not exactly
I'm not
thrilled.
I'm not that far away from you.
If you look at the points now, from first through like sixth or seventh is very bunched.
Yeah.
There's not a lot of diversity.
Unfortunately, well, I lost 3.5 points
unfortunately,
yesterday.
I'm ninth or 10th.
Well, I'm 11th, Kenny. Terry, I'm number 11 is Team Jackass. Number 10 is Brewmaster James with One Nut Puckheads. Number 9, Sexy Terry.
Kill Whitey.
And number 8, Devil Miner. He's crawling his way up for a guy who
does nothing.
I'm pretty sure he's not alive. At number 7, Don't Taves Me. At number 6, Jim and the Punk Monkeys. And number 5, Rookie Mike, Marshawn's a dick.
But look at where my points are. Look at him rolling. Oh,
I know, relax. He's got 70 points. 72 points, Rick Retards at number 4. At 73.5 points,
see?
Number 3.
First spot, 3 points away.
Mal's sick of 69.
Fuck
him. At number 2, Professor Ken's Caner's Bitches, 77 points. At 85.5 points, Steve and the Meatballs.
He's up there ways.
Dominating.
I went away. Whoa. Hold down. I was fucking killing you guys all goddamn season. I never once got the dominating tag.
No, but Ken.
You weren't killing people. You were like.
I had 100 points at one time.
You played
Terry.
Everyone.
Right? I had 105.
You don't got it now. You're at 77 now, Kenny. Yeah.
High watermark. That's because I lost 3.5 yesterday.
That's right. There
no,
you go.
It's not good.
There we are at this point, ladies and gentlemen.
All right. Good night, everybody.
You've been listening to the Bacon and Hockey Podcast. As always, you can check us out on Facebook at Bacon and Hockey Podcast or on Twitter at Bacon and Hockey Podcast. Or you can check us out at baconandhockeypodcast.com. As always, and we promise to check up this time, you can email us at Ken@baconandhockey.com, Jack@baconandhockey.com, Mike@baconandhockey.com. Soon you can do Dan@baconandhockey.com, and of course
LeatheryManSack@baconandhockey.com.
You can please, ladies and gentlemen, call us as America's Wang did. At what's that number, Kenny?
847-242-1571, and make sure you check us out on YouTube.
And YouTube at Bacon and Hockey Podcast.
I believe so.
Facebook.
And Facebook at Bacon and Hockey
what's
Podcast.
That?
Ladies and gentlemen, thanks for listening, and
good night.
We'll check you out. Check us out next week. We'll have more exciting whatever it is we do for you to listen to, and thanks a lot. We'll talk to you next week.
We're out. We're out.
Thanks for the microphone.
Thanks for the booze, Mike. Thanks for bringing a cigar back from
the
Dominican Republic.
Thanks for doing all that you do.